with the owning microphone. Let's get into it. Caledonian Railway 264 Pug Class number 56025 was built in 1890 at St. Wallach's Works for shunting duties. It lived a quiet life, as most shunters were, and was quietly scrapped in 1960 after several years of revenue service. The locomotive would gain its fame 23 years after it was scrapped in 1983, a basic level CR Pug was released by Hornby, and upon being told by a customer how it reminded him of a similar engine with a name chalked on his tanks, Hornby re-released the model under the name Smokey Joe, and has been with Hornby ever since, and the model is still running strong in 2021 without interruption periods. This is Hornby's longest serving model without ever being retooled from release, and in 2020, Hornby did Smokey Joe justice, and a limited edition version was released that year as part of the Centenary range. Speak of the devil, hear he. Okay, let's try this again. Speak of the devil, he shall appear. My model of this famous Hornby icon is one of the Centenary range models bought first hand and is one of the most prized models in my collection. I do own the standard version, which I bought also first hand back in 2015, but that's been altered to slightly look like the real locomotive with the wheel rods. As I've thrown away this guy's box, he's dusty, but I'll clean him eventually and he'll probably get his own video, but no promises. As usual, I will look at the detail of this model, give a rundown of the engine, and give my final. Okay, who did that? Sorry. As I was saying, I will look at the detail, give a rundown of the engine performance, and give my final thoughts of the model. Now, off we go. First glance, the model has a glossy finish to it to distinguish itself from its counterpart of the railroad range since 2011, as it has a matte finish. Another thing to note is the return of the handrails, which disappeared from the Cali Pug model in 1983 and are also picked out in silver. This brings an added level of detail which makes the model worth its value, which cost $75 when it bought it, and eBay listings have it at $130. Yeah, I bought mine at a much lower price than what eBay says, and I'm laughing at it. The buffer beams and buffer shanks are picked out as bright red that almost resembles post office red, but at least that's brilliant they did it. It's strange that in promotional images, the buffer shanks are black, not red. I wonder how this promotional material error was not fixed in the beginning. The molded handrail and door dial are picked out in silver, with the VR number 56025 white on the smokebox door. Tons of rivets are present on the smokebox, which I can't count. Sorry, I'm not a rivet counter. The running board has been a die cast and carries a matte finish, much like what is on the standard model. Both sandboxes feature enormous star hoops points that denote where the level was built and when it was built. Unfortunately, the rhyme's too small for my phone's camera to focus on, but I can put what it says on the screen. The whistle and safety valves and terminal wires that lift the appearance of the locomotive from some cheap toy to a quality model. The main eye catcher to me was the lineup. Since 1983, Smokey Joe looked like this, and 37 years later, it evolved to this. It's so crazy. major difference in the cab, other than the handrail, is the presence of the engine's power classification to the upper sides. The Cali 261 was rated 0F by the LMSFDR, as they had a track record of 10,601 pounds, 47.16 kilonewtons. This, in anyone's books, is definitely not a strong engine, but since this is an 04 Rogue, as they don't need to be too powerful for shunting to use in marshalling yards or industrial sites. Unless you're a dumb yang that overdoes them, because the original's too weak, and not f***ing. Word of warning, from this episode onwards, there's going to be a running gag about the American locomotives. Just warning you. The windows on the cab are done with deluxe materials glue and glaze due to its illusion of stained glass, which my other Smokey Joe has cleared plastic for windows, which I can tell apart despite it being hard to see on camera. Also seen is the fact the engine has no painted interior. I need to get an engine that has the back end painted. This is the third time now. The rods are basic due to what 1980s model railway companies could do at the time for double air gauge engines, but I think a retool of this model is in order. The most eye-catching part is the name written on the water tank, which is just the same as the one on the standard version. Nothing special other than the lined water tank that borders the name. Overall, high level of design, classy little engine with a bright shine. Enough to humiliate the Red Mogul. So, can this Smokey Joe fly off at 1,001,000 miles an hour like how it's famous for, even in railworks? No, the speed in the intro was just a gag based on the famous speed. My first Hornby experience was with this class, but not Smokey Joe, and it did fly at crazy speed. Superbug anyone? The model is powered by the same motor you can find in a Scar Electric slot car. But sometime between 2011 and 2015, they were fitted with a downgraded version of this motor. As a result, this is the actual max speed the engine can go. Trust me, the control is at full power. An improvement, but still ridiculously fast for a shunter. Despite a downright motor, Smokey Joe is still the speedy superbug that everyone has grown up to know since 1983. Just as long as he doesn't. As I was saying, despite the high speeds, he's still popular. Has to be the shortest performance section in my videos. Finally, a tank engine and a famous model is covered in this series. This is one of my favourite models in my motive power collection. While the windows are my only touch, the rest is stock standard for this special release, and just watching it run is a treat. As I've done two episodes of this series, I've decided to make this a main staple of my channel, and I thank all my viewers for this. Also, shout out to Caledonia Works for bringing the 264 class and the Superbug to Railworks. Link in the description to the Caledonia Workshop. Well, after 38 years, Smokey Joe will stand the test of time in Hornby's range, and I hope it reaches 50 years without interruptions. That's all I can say for now. If you like what you see, feel free to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye for now.
It's the life I chose. Gunshots in the dark, one eye closed. And we got it cooking like a one-eye stove. You can catch me kissing my girl with both eyes closed. Yeah. Perfecting my passion, thanks for asking. Couldn't slow down, so we had to crash it. You use plastic, we bout cash. I see some people ahead that we gon' pass, yeah. I never feared death.